Welcome. In this video, we'll see how to interface LCD to 8051. In this circuit, we have interfaced LCD in 4-bit mode. 4-bit mode means the only 4 data lines of LCD are connected to 4 pins of 8051, and remaining 4 pins of LCD are connected to ground. Next, we have connected enable pin to P0.1 and we have connected RS pin to P0.0. We have also connected 2 pull-up resistors to these 2 control signals, and we have used this circuit to adjust the contrast of the LCD. Now we'll see how to write a program for this circuit. So this is the program. So initially we have assigned names to the 2 pins, that is P0.0 is assigned name as RS and P0.1 is assigned name as EN. EN stands for enable, RS stands for resistor select. So from ORG00 the program will start. So the first part is related to initializing the LCD. So the command sent to LCD is 28 hex. So using this command, we can instruct the LCD to operate in 4-bit mode. So this 28 hex command is sent to accumulator. After that, a subroutine named COMWR, that is command write, is called. So we'll just go to that command routine, which is over here. So this is that command routine. So in this command routine, the value which was copied in accumulator is now sent to port 2. It is sent to port 2 because LCD is connected to port 2 upper 4 pins. Next, the RS pin is cleared. So we have to clear the RS pin whenever we want to send command to LCD. After that, we have generated a high to low signal on enable pin. So when we generate this signal, the value which is present on the pins of LCD is latched inside the resistor of LCD. Now, since it is a 4-bit mode, we have to first of all send the upper nibble of data and then the lower nibble of the data. So for that purpose, using this segment of code, we have sent the upper nibble of the data to LCD, and after that we have used the instruction swap A to swap the nibbles, and again same thing is carried out over here. So the lower nibble is now sent to the LCD. In this way, using this command routine, we can send the entire command to LCD, and final instruction is RET, that is return from the subroutine. So when it returns from the subroutine, it will again come back to this location and it will execute the next instruction. So next instruction is ACALL delay. In this, again the delay routine is called. So inside this delay routine, we have taken 2 values, that is 35 and 255 in R3 and R4 resistors respectively, and then the resistor values are decremented. So we'll get a delay with this routine. After that, we have sent the next command, that is 01. So 01 is used for clearing the contents displayed on the LCD. After that, again the same thing is done, that is a command routine is called and a delay routine is also called. Next, the next command sent to LCD is 0C hex. So this is used for turning on the display and cursor off. Again, it is the command routine is called and a delay routine is called. Next command is 80 hex. So using this command, we can display on first line and first position of the LCD. And again, same thing, command routine is called and a delay routine is called. So this is end of the LCD initialization. After that, now we have to start displaying the data. So for displaying the data, we have to send a string to the program. So for that, whatever we want to display on the LCD, that we have to write in the memory at a particular location. So here I have chosen ORG 1000 hex for storing the message. So DB stands for define byte. So in this I have written the message that I want to display and followed by a zero. Zero indicates end of the string. So I have to take the address of the message in the data pointer register. So after that I have cleared the contents of accumulator by taking 00. Next, using this movec instruction, I can copy the ASCII value of the first character in the message inside the accumulator. So with this, the value of DPTR, that is 1000, plus value of accumulator, that is 0. So total address will be 1000 hex. So the first character which is stored or at 1000 hex location will be copied to accumulator. That is, the ASCII value of that character will be copied to accumulator. Next, using this instruction, it will be checked whether that character is the last character or not. So the last character we have written is 0. So if it is 0, it means it is end of the string, and after this the program should stop. And to halt the program, we have used instruction sjump dollar. So dollar means it will keep on jumping at same location. But if the string is not equal to 0, then it will jump to the label next. So the next label is available over here. Here then the instruction used is data equal data write. So data write is again a subroutine which is used for writing data to LCD. So this is that subroutine. So both the command routine and data routine are same, except the difference is set B RS. In case of command routine, it was clear RS. In case of data routine, it is set RS. So whenever we want to write any data on LCD, we have to set the RS pin. So that is the only difference between data routine and command routine. After that, we have called a delay. Then we have incremented the data pointer to point to the next character which is to be displayed. And after that, again, sjump back. So till the entire message is displayed, this program will continue. And once the entire message is displayed, this program will halt. So now we'll just build this program and now check the output on the Proteus software. So this is the circuit. So for that, I have to double click on this IC, select the hex file, and after selecting the hex file, I can play the message. So once I click on play, the message here will be displayed as microcontrollers. So in this way, we can use this Proteus software to interface LCD to 8051. The source code and Proteus simulation file will be available in the description of the video. Thank you.